This playbook is about how to stop and respond to Triton attack. Triton was a cyber attack which was done on petrochemical facilities on the Middle East. It was started on the IT side when the attacker stole the credential of a workstation, managed actually to go over and penetrate the OT side and deploy the malware on an engineering workstation. From that point on, they actually managed to program some PLCs using the TriStation protocol. This is in order actually to disable the safety system and create a second launch attack, which will actually create explosions on the facility, on the factory. So what is the logical flow of the playbook? So basically what we did is once a PLC programming appears, we are going to check whether this is an engineering station or not. This will be done using an Excel file, which is actually a list of all the authorized workstations. If it's yes, then everything is okay. Otherwise, we are going to check if it's during working hours. During working hours, the third check will be if it's from remote access connection using RDP's protocols. The additional test would be if an authorized PC, again from the IT side. And this test, let's say it's not working on the playbook, but it's for demonstration, is actually getting information from MDATP to see or to allocate the malware which was discovered on Triton on Triton attack on the IT workstation. So what we will need for the this playbook, of course the playbook template, we'll need an IP address Excel file, which is a list of all the, let's say, authorized IP addresses, which is going to be uploaded to a OneDrive. And using also the latest Sentinel version, which has automation rules, I will provide everything later on. Step will be creating the playbook from a template. A template can be created only from two ways: from the JSON files itself, JSON templates, or deploying for a GitHub repository from the playbook which exists in GitHub. The first step we're doing over here is we are going to create a custom deploy a custom template. You can see over here, build your own template in the editor. What we are going to do over here is we are going to load it from a file. This is the JSON file that I have prepared in advance. And as you can see, we are actually being populating the text with the file. Now, when we are doing the save, we are required to fill in a few parameters. First one is the resource group. I will choose the CyberX. Here we need actually to fill in a few parameters. So here is the playbook name. I will use Triton PK as a play or PB as a playbook. SOC email addresses. Address. Well, one of the action which is being activated or implemented in the playbook is sent email. So this is actually the email on which each action is going to be sent. And this is actually the username for the subscriptions which are being in use in the playbook. So the next phase will be review and create. We can see that now the playbook is being uploaded to Sentinel. The validation is passed. And now we are creating the playbook. And the next phase will be actually to modify, since the templates are being handed out as an empty template, and we will be required actually to fill in all the gaps in order actually to make it work.
the upload was completed, we can actually go and continue to the next phases. So in the deployment details, what we can see is that we have a new playbook, Triton. We're opening the playbook, and here we have the API connections. These are all the actions or all the connector which are being in use in the playbook. Currently, they are not being in use since they don't have the appropriate username and passwords. So what we can do is we can actually go each one of them for each one of them, and when we're editing the API connection, what we will do is we actually authorize each one of them. It will authorize the connector, and by doing so, we're actually saving time since each one of them appears a few times in the playbook. So there is a need actually to authorize the entire connectors in order actually to make the playbook work. Then again, this should be fairly easy. And that's it. Okay, now we actually made all the connections. If we will go to the playbook itself, what we'll see on the logic of designer, we'll see that now there is a requirement for connections, but then again, he has a new connection. We can either use I did further one, so he asked me to choose one. I can actually choose, and basically once there is no triangle like this, everything is working okay. Same is for here. There is no need. You won't be required to do it. I just need to choose from one of my connections, and from that point on, we can go over to the Excel part. Before we'll continue with the Excel connector, first we need an Excel file. So this here we actually I prepared a column or one column. It's not a full table. We know the column. We will need the column name. This is what the connector will require. An additional thing is an Excel table. So in order to create an Excel table, basically what there is needed is to actually mark the entire table. Here we have only one column, but if there are more, so there is a need to actually mark all of them. And then insert a table. Now, as you can see here, it's great, but over here we have a table, and we can actually configure the table name. So when we are configuring the connector, what we will need is the column name and the table name. Okay, so the next phase will be to configure the Excel connector. The Excel connector, as you can see, has a few parameters. So the first one is the location. So as I said, we need it on the Google Drive, on the OneDrive. It depends on the OneDrive that you are configured. What's a OneDrive, a regular for business. The next, it will be actually to looking for the document library. So it's we can see it's a OneDrive. Now from that point on, it actually ask for the file path. So I've already put the file in my OneDrive, but as you can see, it can actually requires the path and what we had chosen the file it's been put. And these are the two parameters that I have discussed before. This is the table name and the column name. Now, this is the key value, which is being taken from variables which are being determined up. This part might be changed, but then again, this is something which does not require any configuration. This is a part of the playbook. We created the playbook, it's configured. And now the next thing is actually to correlate it with the incidents which are coming from incident with Sentinel. Each incident can trigger a playbook, and now we're going to configure the way or to relate between an incident and playbook. So this is being done on Azure Sentinel. We're going to analytics, and we are going to create new role. An incident creation role. We can call it PLC programming, or the source of the information is Azure Security Center for IoT. Now over here we can actually include specific alerts. So for here we have for PLC or programming or any other word we can actually use. And now we are going to configure the automated response. So now this is Triton or whatever. We actually created a trigger, and now we are going actually to define what is going to be the action. So the action is going to be a playbook. He's looking for the relevant playbooks. And from here, we can actually choose which is the playbook. As you can see, there are many playbooks which are available. This is our playbook, and we'll apply it. And that's it. We have a rule which actually attaches between the incident and the playbook. The last part will be a demonstration of how the playbook works. So, in order to make it work, we prepared in advance pickup with an authorized PLC programming. So we are going to play the pickups, and over here we can see that in a second we will have an unauthorized PLC programming command alert. Now what happens is that basically the alert is going to Sentinel, and what we will see is we'll see two things. One, we'll see the a message in Teams, which actually details this is the test, but in a minute we'll see the message. Now for Teams, there is a need actually to create a dedicated channel, since the playbook connector is not working with chats. So there is a need to create a channel on Teams. I created the channel and assigned only myself. This is how it's going to work on the SOC. Here you can see that I received a message, a Teams message, which said that something was happened. And in a few seconds, I will receive a mail as well, which also details that something has happened. And I received an email which has the same information, and yet then again, it's an additional channel which allows us to explore or to reach or to activate actions which are based on more than one channel. Then again, it can be on the SOC, it can be on the analyst, maybe different channels, one for the teams of the SOC analyst and additional for the management. And in this way, we can actually allow SOC teams actually to have a few channels of communication. So we will wait a few seconds. And here, as you can see, this is the email. This is probably an attempt that I did before, but as you can see, the same text appears also in the email.